At the Chrome Dev Summit, I showed off a contacts app I built which let me scroll through hundreds of friends all at a very snappy 60 frames per second. But dropping hundreds or maybe even like thousands of DOM elements on screen can really blow your performance budget. So how do you do it? I'm Rob Dodson. Today on Polycasts, I'm going to show you how to scroll through thousands of items using nothing but HTML. Let's check it out. Now, the trick to rendering lots of stuff on screen is to actually only render a few items at a time and then recycle those items super fast. So as one item goes off screen, we move it back down to the bottom and actually update its content in the process. This way, we don't have to pay the cost of creating thousands of items. We might only create a pool of like 20 items and then reuse those over and over again. So to do this, I'm going to be using an element called core list. It's one of my absolute most favorite elements. And what it is a virtualized infinite list. You've got a data provider, which is just an array of objects. And you can connect that to a template. And for every instance of that template inside of your core list, it will stamp out an item to match your data provider. What's really cool about this is you can use data bindings inside of this template. So if I want to take the name property right here, I can just pipe it right into my template, where model refers to the actual instance in the data provider, name refers to that property. So really, really cool. And what it lets you do is very easily throw together something like this, a little mobile contacts list. And that's exactly what we're going to be building today. So now that you see how core list works, let's hop into the editor and get this thing rolling. So the first thing I'm going to do is hop into my bower.json file. I've got a core list, core image, and a library inside of here called Faker.js, which I'm going to use to generate some dummy data for my application. Then over in my terminal, I'm going to run bower install to add everything to my project. Then back in my editor, I will open up my elements.html file and write out an import for the core list element. And the thing that I often find tricky about working with core lists is making sure that I've got the right height set on it. In this case, I want my list to be as big as the screen itself, so I'm going to use some layout attributes to pull that off. So I will set my body element to have a full bleed, fit, layout, and vertical attributes on it. And then we'll add a core list element with a flex attribute. And what that's going to do is tell the core list element to stretch to fill the body. Now, inside of my core list, I'm going to create a template. And inside of that template, I will put a div and give that div a class of row. This is where I'm going to store all of my row items. Inside of the row, I'll create another div and give it a data binding for model.name. Now, for the core list to work properly, it needs to know the approximate height of all of the row items inside of it. And by default, it expects a row item to be about 80 pixels high. So in my CSS, I will write out some styles to force that row div that I created to be 80 pixels high. And if you wanted to have some items that are different sizes, you could also set a height attribute on the core list itself. And you'd want that height to be the average of all your different items. I may do a future video to show off how to do variable height items if you guys are interested in that. Now, because I want to pipe some data into my list, I'm going to wrap everything inside of an auto binding template. And I'm also going to give my template an ID of app, so that way I can refer to it later using JavaScript. Then I'm going to include the Faker.js library down here at the bottom, basically right above my app.js file, because that's where I'm going to need to use it. And I can just grab that out of my Bower components directory. Then I will pop open app.js. And inside of here, I'm just going to create a function called generateContacts. And what it is just a for loop. It's got about 1,000 items in it. It's going to return an array of data objects using Faker.js. Then I will grab a reference to my autobinding template, and I will set the autobinding template's data property equal to the return value of generateContacts. And the last thing I need to do is connect my core list to that data. So inside of my template, I will just set data equals, and I will bind to the data scope variable. And there we go. My data provider is connected to my list, and I'm ready to rock. So if I hop up into my browser, you'll see that I'm now generating about 1,000 items inside this contact list, and I can scroll through them really fast. And the frame rate on this video may not be capturing it, but try it yourself, and you should be getting around 60 frames per second. So the contact list is nice and snappy, but it's also pretty boring to look at. Let me drop in some profile photos, and while I'm at it, I'm going to show you a really cool trick. So I'm going to pop up in my elements.html file, and I'm going to add an import for the core image element. Then I'm going to add a core image inside of my row. I'll give my core image some attributes. I'll give it a class of avatar. I will tell it to pull its data from the data provider's avatar property. I'm going to set a preload attribute and also give it a sizing style of cover. I'm also going to tell my row to lay out all of its children horizontally centered. And what that means is if a row was sort of like a rectangle, then my avatar image would appear over here on the left. And then centered with it vertically would be all of the text for my model's name. Now, the reason why I'm using a core image here instead of just using a regular image from my avatar is because of this preload attribute. Basically, because our core list element is a virtualized list that is recycling its children over and over again, it runs the risk of displaying stale images if the image has not had a chance to load yet. With core image and with this preload attribute, what will happen is it will actually display either a default background color or a stand-in background image while it waits for the image content to actually load in. So rather than seeing stale items flying through my list that then suddenly change, you'll see a sort of placeholder scroll through the list, and then the image itself will load in. Now, to style my avatar, I'm going to give it an explicit width and height, and also give it a border radius so that it's nice and round. Lastly, I'll give it a background color, which will display while that image is preloading. Now, if we go and preview this in the browser, you can see that I've now got my avatar images, I've got my contact names to the right, and it's scrolling through really fast. But some of you may have noticed something a little funny as this thing is scrolling. Pay attention to this guy right here, and look at what happens when I scroll back up. Yeah, see that? It's the same dude. So what's going on here? Well, what we've run into is a bug in core list. And what do when we have a bug? Well, we bust out the So that's exactly what I'm going to do now. I'm going to show you how to work around this little issue. But before I do that, I also want to point out that I have included a link to the GitHub issue down in the show notes. You can follow along to see when this bug is fixed. Basically, this is a problem, I believe, with Object Observe. And there's two ways to fix it. You can either create your own Polymer element and put your core list inside of this new custom element that you've created. This seems to fix the problem. Or if you want, you can use an auto-binding template like I am here. And then you need to include a binding for the list item's index. And this can kind of just be like a throwaway. You can sort of hide it somewhere. What I'm going to do is actually create an attribute on both my core image and my div. And I'm going to set this data index attribute that I've made up to the value of the list item's index. And what this does is it basically kind of magically pokes object.observe, and it fixes our little bug here. Now, you know, these index values are not going to render, so it's kind of OK to do this. And again, this is just sort of a workaround for this temporary issue. And now we can preview this in our browser, and you'll notice that as we are scrolling through the page, the background images are displaying that preloader placeholder color. And that's sort of verification that you know that it's actually going out and fetching new images instead of the issue we had before where it was recycling them. There you have it. With core list, you can scroll through a ton of content at a buttery smooth 60 frames per second. That's it for today. Be sure to click the subscribe button to get more of these Polycasts. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.